Craig van Horne. I have a MD and a PhD, work in the Department of Neurosurgery, and my subspecialty is functional disorders, Parkinson's disease, essential tremor, and so my specialty with that is deep brain stimulation. You know, even from, you know, grade school, I was more interested in the biological kinds of things, and we'd learn about the heart and stuff like that. And so I always just kind of gravitated towards those kinds of subjects. And in high school, I loved biology. And when I got into college, I developed more of an interest in the neurosciences. Although, you know, taking care of patients is very satisfactory, there's still, you know, we're limited. We do standard of care, but what about the patients who have needs beyond that? We don't have good therapies for that. So I like that idea of being able to develop a new therapy or figuring out what the problem is and how do we work around that. We really need to do an assessment of what do they have, what other forms of treatments, you know, are successful, what are things are not successful, what can we build on that is known and is working, and what can we focus on that is not working, and where could we, you know, possibly surgery is going to be an option, but not everybody needs surgery. And so there, we'll try other non-surgical options first, but if it gets to that point that other forms of medicine don't work, then surgery oftentimes is the best option and becomes the standard of care. Yeah, what we are really focusing on now is Parkinson's disease. And the problem with Parkinson's is that it's a neurodegenerative process that is continuous, and patients just slowly and steadily get worse. Their symptoms get worse. There isn't anything that slows that process down. We have good medical treatments that are effective in the early parts of the illness, but then as the disease gets worse, then those treatments become less and less effective. Then surgery becomes an option, and we can do deep brain stimulation where we insert stimulating electrodes into the brain to help the symptoms. But as effective as that is for many patients, it still doesn't slow the progression of the disease. So what we're really focusing on in the laboratory are therapies that are disease altering or disease modifying. So if we can slow down, stop, or reverse the neurodegeneration that we see in Parkinson's disease, then we would really consider that a big victory. The coolest part of my job is just the fact that I get to do what I do. And I still have absolute awe and wonder every time during a craniotomy or we open up the skull and you can actually see the brain, and being able to work with the human brain, I think is like just one of the coolest things ever.